We're now joined by Mr. Harald Tan, who is the author of the book, Earning Your First Million in Stocks. Good afternoon and welcome to Market Edge, Harald.
Good afternoon, Stanley. Thanks for having me.
It's good to have you here. Now, the PSEI closed in the red today at 66.76, down by 0.25%. Value turnovers, just 4 billion pesos. Except for financials and services, most of the counters are down. What triggered today's bearish sentiment?
I think investors are staying on the sidelines waiting for the BSP announcement of inflation data tomorrow.
Okay.
And we can expect that the index will trend in a range between of 65 to 6800. The breakout to the upside that happened last week at 6800 is just a bull trap. So I would caution investors when trading this market in times of uncertainties, or better yet, to buy it around 6500 level if 6500 level holds.
All right, that 6,500 level as immediate support. Now, talking about inflation, the print is due out tomorrow. Consensus for most analysts is around 6.4%, which is on the higher band, but within government's target range, of course, of 5.9 to 6.7%. What's your inflation forecast for next month, given that the easing of world oil prices, whose effect will only be felt after tomorrow's CPI release, and many other developments expected for September?
I think the biggest contributors are the basic consumption needs. And if we take a look with them, salt, garlic, onions, and even eggs and pending pear, right, is still increasing. With that respect, I guess the inflation would be trending higher or will be ending up on the higher spectrum if these issues would not be solved. And of course, we also need to factor in the worst case scenario, say that the inflation might reach more than 7%. If that's so, we could not get off guard since we already included that in our risk analysis when participating in the market.
Okay, of course, we have inflation on one side and currency problems on the other. Let's talk about the value of the peso hitting almost 57 to a dollar, reaching its historical highs of 56.45 from 2004. How is the market digesting this today, given the far-reaching effect on businesses, especially those involved in or even relying on imports?
This is expected. The breakout of all-time high at 56.46, if you review the technical and aspect of the chart since way back on June. So that will... the breakout on that upside will cause the rally. However, I can see a minor divergence in the chart here. So we can expect that this level would be retested, the 56.46. Short-term target would be around 57.6 to 58.80 peso versus the dollar. Of course, the worst-case scenario would be around 60 for short to intermediary term. So again, we factor in the worst case scenario so that we would not be caught off guard.
And the best case scenario, we will end 2022 with how much?
I think in the range of 57.6 to 58.8.
All right, let's talk about initial public offers now on the IPO front. We have an upcoming debut for Upsun International, which contains Octagon Computer, Micro Valley, Gadget King in the basket. The SEC has cleared its fundraising of over 4 billion pesos. What are your thoughts on this play?
I haven't reviewed the prospectus of this company, if any, but we cannot expect a speculative play due to the large capitalization. So I would think on its IPO debut, the possibilities is the stock to trade lower than the IPO prices like Monte, or up for around like 10 to 15% maximum. Of course, for investors, I would highly advise to avoid buying them during the IPO offering, but rather wait until the market to establish a trend for you to have a lesser risk entry. Let's say around like 1 to 2 months before you pump in the market, since the first few weeks or first few days will have a higher volatility as we expected for the newly upcoming IPOs.
Okay, corporate stories now. Megawide divesting from the airport project in Cebu and into affordable housing as well as transport. In fact, Aboitiz Equity Venture has signed the agreement for that purchase. What do you make of this transition for this company? Is there still money to be made in saturated affordable housing ecosystem?
I think in times of uncertainties and a threat of a recession in US, I guess if that will happen, the real estate sector and banking sector will be hit badly because of the monetary restriction and high interest rate. Default will increase and will impact the company itself. Right now, I am not seeing an attractive upside with the stock, so I would rather not chase prices and look for a better opportunity.
Lastly, Harold, you've written a book, Earning Your First Million in Stocks. Now, what mindset must someone have that you can share to achieve a goal like that, especially during this time of volatility and extreme unpredictability? Please sum it up for us.
It is always expected that the market to be uncertain. And of course, volatility is a good thing for us to make money. And for you to combat uncertainty, it is for you to manage your risk appropriately. You need to always factor every possible scenario that the market can go against you, so you will not be caught off guard, because good things will take care of itself. But if you caught unprepared, then you cannot make a sound decision. Basically, every open position that I have, I would ask myself, is there anything that I don't know about that I would not be that too optimistic?
Okay, and one more question perhaps. Is it really difficult to make a million in these times?
Of course, the question, you need to paraphrase the question, is that you before you should earn a million, of course, the question is how much is your disposable capital? Mm-hmm. Your disposable capital is around 10,000. Of course, it will be a very long time. But I think a minimum capital of around 300,000 is achievable. You can earn that, I guess, in around 1 or 2 years if you are really good enough. And second thing, you need to focus on in developing your proven system. That is what I am always teaching the public, that you need to have a profitable system that you can repeat it consistently, so that you will not just guess the market is going up or going down and, you know, just make random decisions. So you have to have a system in trading or investing in the market.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot, Mr. Harold Tan, author of the book Earning Your First Million in Stocks. Thanks a lot for your market guidance. Have a great day.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure to be here.